r/AskReddit by Planet Reddit. Gamers. What's the strangest encounter you've had with players online? Had some guy just start reading 50 Shades of Grey on GTAV. The whole chat went silent as we all listened, only to erupt into laughter as the guy reading finally lost his composure. Who is Jeff and how did you meet him? In TF2 there was a guy with no mic who decided to be my pocket medic, which means a medic that runs off with me instead of staying with the primary group of teammates. But he took this to absurd lengths. He would never heal anyone but me. An ally scout that was currently on fire came running up to get healed saved and the medic just watched him die. Then every time he ubered me, made me invincible for 10 seconds, he'd blast Flight of the Valkyries over chat. And it was an all chat server so the enemy team could hear it too. Sometimes he'd turn it on even when he didn't have a Uber charge ready and people would start retreating thinking he was about to Uber me. This went on for like an hour. He healed no one else. Said nothing. Typed nothing. And Ubered me dozens of times. Then he left. And gifted me vintage hat that was worth like 10 bucks. And then didn't accept my friend request. Oh god. This is a great idea. I should do this. I never play TF2 anymore. So I might as well give a noob a cool hat. I was playing a game of Mount and Blade. Napoleonic Wars, bear in mind each game has 250 players. My team was defending a large house surrounded by walls. A unique thing about the game is that you can choose to play bagpipers and various other characters with musical instruments. So I was running around the house and I saw a piano. So I went over and started picking tunes to play on it. A few seconds later a squad of musicians come running down the stairs and just start playing with me. Eventually almost the entire team was down there dancing by toggling crouch. Out of nowhere a cannonball came flying through the wall and the piano and killed me. Then all of a sudden on chat someone typed. They killed the piano man. And a few moments later someone else typed. Forward. For the piano man. And then charged out of the newly formed hole in the wall and the entire team followed shouting the same in the chat. It was hilarious and bewildering at the same time. Was it 9 o'clock on a Saturday? Were they the regular crowd? Would play Splinter Cell multiplayer way back. One of the many neat features of that game was cross teams comms would only work when the spy had the merc and a chokehold. You could essentially whisper something into your enemy's ear before you choked them out or snap neck finish them. One occasion I was playing as a merc and got caught up by a spy and over my earpiece I heard Taste the Rainbow Beach and he snapped my neck. I laughed so hard. I was playing R6 Siege a few months ago and we had a team member who would say exactly this over voice chat when he killed someone. In the game Elite. Dangerous. I was flying around in a more populated area when I got interdicted by a wing of Orcus, very large fast ship. Great for ramming other ships. One of the players rings my ship for voice comms and I accept. Hoping to talk my way out of a hostile situation. Nope. He blasts circus music and they all start flying at me at insane speeds. I didn't get away. But I laughed in the end. That's perfect. Shit like this is my favorite part of multiplayer games. I played Gary's mod a lot a few years ago. One time our base was being raided and something similar happened. We were vastly outnumbered and we were all going to die. The raiders played the Titanic theme through their voice chat the whole time. They made us surrender. Lined us up against the wall. Changed the song to Toxic by Britney. And then executed us. I was helping people defeat a particular boss in Dark Souls, Seath the Scaleless. There was this one guy that I had been connecting to all night amidst the other people. After maybe 3 hours of helping people, I had connected to his world like 10 times. And still no luck. After a while, I decided to switch it up and start invading. Well, I ended up in his world again. As an invader this time. Instead of an ally. I was so emotionally torn. You can't communicate directly in Dark Souls multiplayer. But you can use some basic gestures. We had shared all sorts of funny moments together. And sort of became wordless friends over the course of the evening. So now. Unsure of what to do. I just unequipped all of my weapons and turned my back to him to show vulnerability and trust. And well. He did the same in response. After a little dancing. We headed into the dungeon. as an invader. I couldn't hurt any of the enemies. But I just went up and swung my sword at them anyways. I just kind of pretended to be his ally. And we made it to the boss door again together. Once we were there, we both stood still for a while. We spun around a bit, unsure of how to proceed. I went up to him. Dropped 5 humanity items. It's a useful item in the game. Not super rare, but convenient to get for free. Waved at him and ran off a cliff, leaving him free to fight the boss. I never connected to his world again. So as far as I can tell, he was able to do it alone after all, with a little encouragement along the way. In DS3, I was invaded by a watchdog who had no weapon, no armor, and wearing a symbol of avarice. He ran around the bonfire dropping 50 symbols of avarice until he died from the health loss. It was silly. Those invasions are the best. Ironically, some of my best encounters in that game were some real heavy-handed cheaters using their superpowers to do dumb, weird shit. When you just got stunlocked then launched off a cliff for the nth time. Having a weird glowing red demon man enter your game and start flying around in bizarre poses dropping rainbow stone carpet bombs. And ultimately launching into space straight out of your world again really helps take the edge off. Though I suppose in DS3, they could have actually been legit symbols of avarice farmed up using Lloyd's talismans. But who has the time for that? The answer? A lot of people. Modern Warfare 2. I've posted about this before on a different thread. I forget the name of the map. But it was the big grass one with the radioactive perimeter and the cave bunker in the middle. I've been told it's Wasteland. My friends and I would all equip riot shields and move around like Spartans in the phalanx formation. Without talking to the other team or communicating with them in any way. They also started moving in the phalanx formation. And eventually it evolved into a riot shield fight club inside the bunker. Two guys would go into the middle and start ramming each other with their shields while the rest of us were standing around them in a circle. Jumping. It was one of the funniest and strangest things I have ever seen. The fact that there is another group of friends out there as weird as mine. And we ran into them was very surprising. I came up with the idea of having everyone on our team equip cold-blooded pro. Don't show up on radar and no name pops up when you're in the crushers, and a sniper class, say you have a ghillie suit, and then hide. Each MW2 map had a couple good hiding places and we planned them out ahead of time. We were playing TDM on Rundown and we all jumped into the bushes on the perimeter of the map and were laughing as people would run by us. The other team was running around the map confused because they could see that the other team was full but couldn't find anyone. With the match almost over, one player on the other team finds us and realizes what we were doing so doesn't shoot us. He stayed by us and started jumping around, which drew the attention of someone else on his team who, with 10 seconds left, threw a grenade and killed all of us. When the match ended and chat opened up, there was hysterical laughter coming from both sides. I miss that game. We played high to haha. Usually the other team would get frustrated and start killing themselves. W and somebody on their team got close, it added so much more tension to the game than running around actually going for kills. Playing RuneScape back in the day. This girl met me can I be a GF and followed me around all day and kept world hopping when I switched worlds. Not sure if he was serious or trolling. But it was for a good 5-6 hours. I remember going to a house in that game and two players. A male and a female. Declared they were GF and BF. Went into a bedroom. Stood next to the bed and started typing sex noises into the chat. Weird as duck. This is not a dating site. Traveling with a friend on day Z. We're playing on a semi-RP server. So cost generally doesn't happen and you're supposed to try and interact with each other. Yano. Talk things out. Well. We noticed that someone was following us as we looted around town. We had a car fixed up. So we decide to get the hell out of there just in case. We don't shoot him on sight because of the server rules. About an hour later. We're basically on the other side of the map looting up the Myshkino military base. We often check our car. Make sure nobody is messing with it. Sure enough. That same guy is there again. And he's messing with our car's infantry. We fire a few warning shots and he takes off into the woods. My friend is shouting over the mic that he's gonna get that mofo. He's chasing him into the woods. but I stopped to check our car. See what he took. Yuck now. I burst out laughing. Me. Dude. Let him go. He didn't take anything, friend. What? Why was he messing with the car? Me. Bro. He filled our entire car with pieces of paper. There's like 60 pieces of paper in here. And they all say paper, 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 paper in red ink. Literally every single one had been wrote on. Back in the day, I was on a random Minecraft server and I left my base to go mining. When I got back, I saw someone inside and asked in the chat why he was in there. He asked for my Skype name and then called me. What happened next was a hostage situation. He'd rigged my house with TNT and said if I didn't give him all my valuables, he'd blow the house up. Server had locked chests but not any anti-griefing systems. To prove he was serious, he took my dog to the window and killed him. A few of the mods from the server were online and nearby. So came over and asked if they wanted me to kick and ban him. I thought it was quite funny, so let it play out. And tried to talk. That lasted a second before he blew the place up. Happy ending though. They banned him then helped me build a new house. RIP Cecil though. It's kinda fun with an adult. But imagine doing that to a 10-year-old kid who spent his past 6 months building the house and taming a dog of his own. Have you seen kids play Minecraft these days? They'll do in 20 minutes what an adult'll take days to accomplish. It's mental. I was playing GTA Online a few months ago when a group of 4 guys in stealth military gear pulled up to me in their armored car. They all got out and pointed their guns at me, telling me to get in. Me, being a quite passive player, decided to go with the roleplay and get in. We drove for about 10 minutes while they squabbled with each other about what to do with me until we reached this abandoned lumber yard deep in the woods. There, they escorted me inside where I was forced to stay in the corner. 2 of them went outside to meet with another guy, my buyer I assume. I decided that this might be the time to leave, so I came up with an interesting way to escape. I put a bounty on their heads. Called muggers to come rob them. Called in a private militia to distract them. And I called Lester, Hackerman, to hide my marker on the map once they all arrived to fight my captors. A firefight ensued. I jumped through a window and ran away into the woods for a minute or two when I came across a railway. I could hear them in the distance, realizing that I was gone, and they ran after me since my marker had reappeared by now. Deus Ex Machina kicked in and the train arrived just before they got the killing shot on me. So I hopped into the train and zipped away. They got into their armored car and followed me while I tried to shoot out their tires. They had just about caught up with me when another player on the server arrived to come help me in his attack chopper. My new friend killed the captors, picked me up, and flew me back to the city where I hid in his company headquarters. We smoked some weed and drank some whiskey while half the server waited patiently outside the building for me to come outside. Whoa, as a lover of online shooters survival type games. Am I missing a gem by not playing GTA Online? This sounds awesome. Unfortunately, this type of thing is like a 1 in a million chance event. The game can be extremely fun if you have some friends to be in a lobby with. But otherwise you'll mostly meet with Russians that want to test their new turret out on you. Eve is plenty weird, so mine is sort of mundane, but whatever. As a brief primer on Eve. In normal space, there is this thing called local, which is the chat window for the system. It lists all players currently in the system. So you always know if there's someone there. Then there's wormhole space. There is no local. You only appear there once you enter a message into the chat window. You could be surrounded by 20 players ready to murder you and you wouldn't know till you went pop. There is a thing called scan though that reveals most ships in the local area around you, which is to say around 14.3 or. Part of the culture of wormhole space then is that you don't talk in local. Ever. Not for any reason. This led to an odd situation once upon a time when I was running around in wormhole space. I had named my ship Please Don't Shoot or something similar. I hit my scan and discovered a ship called Oh Yes I Will. In jest. I renamed my ship to Please No. On my next scan hit. The ship had changed to Coming to Kill You. I then proceeded to have a conversation for a few minutes purely by constantly changing the name of my ship and never once using the chat function provided in game. Back when I played Eve, me and a few buddies went on a wormhole gas mining adventure. I think we were three minors, myself included, and two stealth escorts. Don't remember what types of ships, so we weren't completely without protection, but it was still pretty risky. Everything was super quiet that day when suddenly the chat starts blowing up with this group of 7 or 8 guys typing the lyrics to Bohemian Rhapsody into the chat. We noped out of there very quickly. I played Eve for maybe 1 week and I loved it. I worked super hard for my ship, the Execura. But then I got mugged and they took my ship and killed my escape pod, so I said forget that and never played again. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for 3 videos a day.